我听 OK。
好，各位，不管是线上的弟兄姐妹，或者是在这里实体的弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Good evening to all of you。
我们今天非常特别的晚上。
Tonight is a very special night。
我整天主持聚会啊，讲哦，这个是一个很特别的机会，都是客套话来的，讲下不了了。
I always organize some meetings. Always, I would say there's a special meeting. It's all, these are all
normal saying.
Normal saying lah. Okay.
不过今天真的是一个很特别的一个日子。
Tonight is really a very special night.
因为我们的嘉宾讲员是我们想要请都请不到的。
Because tonight's speaker are the speaker that we want to, Even we ask him to come, also very difficult to ask.
而且我们的讲员也真的很不容易，我们能够有他在我们当中。
So we also are very glad that our speaker here today are very difficult to ask him to come.
我们掌声欢迎我们的讲员 Reverend Alex Awad.
Let us welcome our dear speaker tonight, Dr. Alex Awad.
Reverend Alex Awad 是巴勒斯坦人啊。
Reverend Dr. Alex Awad is a Palestinian.
不是以色列人啊，不是犹太人，是真的巴勒斯坦人啊，各位。
He is a Palestinian, not.Israel Jews is a Palestinian.
如果你要我讲到再直接一点，就是被炸的那一方。
He's the one that under attack.
他们都是难民。
So most of them are refugees.
马来西亚也好多巴勒斯坦的难民。
In Malaysia, actually, we have quite a number of refugees as well.
可是当我们每一次谈到这些事件的时候，我们都会有一个感觉，就是哎呀，这种政治的东西，我们也不知道谁对谁错了啊。
So normally when we come across to this topic, normally we will say that, this is not my business. We also don't know who is right, who is wrong. Normally we don't talk about it.
然后在神学上，教会很容易就会倾向，我们一直支持犹太人，支持以色列，因为上帝的选民嘛。
So normally when the church talk about the issue of Israel and Palestinian, we will say that no, we have to support Israel because it is the people of God.
今天晚上我们试试看去聆听不同的角度的故事。
So tonight, let us use a different perspective to listen to the other side of the story.
更重要的是，我们不仅是要听故事，我们盼望透过这些故事，我们思考上帝的心意是什么。
So not only we listen to story, but we actually through the story we try to understand what actually God will say about this.
那这里我们先要做一点介绍或者是一些的问题哦。
Okay, 这个。
这个Reverend Alex Awad 是刚才已经讲了，他是耶路撒冷这个伯利恒神学院的讲师，现在他是全世界很重要的一位分享者，去在全世界 travel 去把这个巴勒斯坦的议题告诉给全球的。
Reverend Alex Awad is the Palestinian Arab who grew up in Jerusalem and he used to be the rector of the Bethlehem Bible College. So now he already retired. So he went over all over the world to actually to let other know about the issue of Palestinians and Israel.
哪一本书要跟大家分享的？就是Pastor Alex 的著作。
So there's a book that Pastor Alex wrote.
我本来要拿上来介绍了这本书。
That's okay here.
不过听说卖完了，我介绍都没有书。不过我如果是现场实体参加的弟兄姐妹，我们还想买的话，可以跟 Kim 留个名字，我们再过后算算看有多少本，我们再 order。
So if you want to purchase this book, if you are here now, so let order from Kim that we can actually have the number that we can order later.
巴勒斯坦回忆录。一个 巴勒斯坦母亲和他同胞的故事。
So, this book is name is called Palestinian Memories, the story of a Palestinian mother and her people.
这本书记载了Pastor Alex Awad的家族的故事。
So, this is a story about Pastor Alex Awad, his family, history.
也记载了整个巴勒斯坦的历史的故事。
So through his story, we can actually see the whole, history of the Palestinian as well.
那我们在开始还没有请 Pastor Alex 上来分享之前呢，我们先抛一些的问题给大家来一起先思考哦。我们带着这些问题来想一想。
So, before we start, we want to actually ask a few questions to all of the audience here.
OK， 那如果是现场也好，或者是线上也好，我们可以 scan 这个 QR code， 可以进去。
If you are here, you can actually scan the QR code. For those who are online, also you can scan. So we let us know about this, and we can have the number later.
OK， 等一下我们来一起做个讨论啊，这个。
So the question actually, have you ever had any contact withinteract with the Christians from the Palestinian regions， 就是你是否曾经接触和交流过巴勒斯坦地区的基督徒吗？如果你有的话就放有，没有的话就放没有，你可以 scan 了，然后你就放上去，等一下我们来看那个答案。
OK，
好，
好，接下来我们就要这些是过后、过后才看的。OK， 好，这样各位，等一下我们进入这个QR code 过后，我们可以在里面来交流。然后等一下我们也会有 Q&A 的那个时段。那这个时刻我们就不再多说了，我们就要把时间交给我们今晚上的讲员。
So we will have the Q&A question later. So we will ask our speaker to come forward.To help us in this.
Let's welcome Pastor Alex.
Let's welcome Pastor Alex.
Maybe somebody will take a picture of this.
Yeah, they will.
You want to use mine? Okay, you have both the English and the Chinese?
No, English is here. Then you can have.
I need maybe a few more books here to make it up a little higher.
Good. Oh, I can let you.
That's good. That is good. That is good. Okay. Here we go.
Yeah. Let us.
I don't need it. I don't need this.
Okay.
Only you need it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll just.
Yes, it's okay.
But you can look at me when I change mine. You can change yours.
No problem.
That's good. Yeah.
有了吗，Simon？
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum. Let us fix the mic for you.
Hello. Hello, testing 1, 2.
Okay.
Yeah. Shall I start off?
Yeah.
All right. Good evening, everyone.
大家平安。
I am delighted to be with you.
我很高兴与大家同在。
And thank you, Pastor, for inviting me.
Thank you for coming.
Can we sing something in Chinese?
我们可以 sing. Okay.
Yeah, sing something Chinese.
我们可以唱一些东西吗?
Okay. Let's short chorus.
Short chorus. Okay. 我们唱一个短短的歌. Yeah. Sing. What to sing?
Okay. Let's sing. Do they know we shall overcome in Chinese?
I don't think they
know. Okay. Okay, this is the day. Okay, this is the day that the Lord has made.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has came. 会吗？可以吗？
Okay, all right.
Okay, 我们一起唱好吗？ 这是耶和华，这是耶和华，说定的日子，说定的日子。 我们在其中，我们在其中，也高兴欢呼，也高兴欢呼。 这是耶和华说定的日子。 我们在其中的人心欢呼，这是耶和华，这是耶和华所定的日子。
You know, I'm not a singer, but just for your sake, I'll sing it in Arabic.
Okay, 牧师会用阿拉伯文向我们来唱。
You probably never heard a Christian song in Arabic.
我相信你们没有听过阿拉伯文的基督徒的基督教的歌。
إن هذا اليوم إن هذا اليوم ربنا صنع ربنا صنع فلنبتهج أيضا نفرح فيه إن هذا اليوم ربنا صنع فلنبتهج أيضا نفرح إن هذا اليوم إن هذا اليوم ربنا صنع. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You know, we are one family.
我们是一家人.
We may have many languages.
我们有很多的语言.
Many races.
我们有不同的种族.
But we are one in Christ.
我们在基督里是一家人.
And I come to Malaysia.
我来到马来西亚.
To share with you a little bit about the church in the Holy Land.
我要向你们来分享在圣地里的教会。
My desire is that you will start praying for the church in the Holy Land.
我的意愿就是你会为圣地里的教会来祷告。
All Palestinians have a hard time.
巴勒斯坦人在苦难的当中。
I'm sure you've been watching the news.
我相信你有看到新闻的报道。
And you saw the genocide that's happening in the Holy Land.
你看到现在在这个圣地里面发生的种族灭绝的事情是非常痛心的。
But the Christians in the Holy Land are suffering along with the Muslims.
你要知道其实在圣地里面基督徒和回教徒都在苦难的当中。
So when you hear about people killed, they are not just numbers, they are both Muslims and Christians.
所以当你听到在这个新闻里面报道的这些被杀的人的时候，他们不是一个号码，他是人，而是死，就是受苦的人。
And this may hurt the future of the Church of the Holy Land.
这将会伤害到在未来在这个圣地里面的教会。
So the Palestinian Christians should pray for Malaysian Christians.
在巴勒斯坦的基督徒会为马来西亚的基督徒祷告。
And Malaysian Christians should pray for Palestinian Christians.
在马来西亚的基督徒也应该要为巴勒斯坦的基督徒来祷告。
And we all should pray for everybody, including Muslims.
我们也应该不只是为基督徒，我们还要为所有的人来祷告。
Because the God who created the Christians also created the Muslims.
是我们的上帝不单单是创造基督徒，他也创造了非信徒。
He is a good God and He loves all.
他是爱我们的上帝，他爱世人。
So now I want to talk a little bit about the situation in the Holy Land.
我想在这个时候跟你们分享一下现在发生在这个巴勒斯坦的事情。
So let's look at this one.
我们来看看这个画面上的这个照片。
You know, in October 5, I took a group of American tourists to the Holy Land.
在去年的10月5号，我带了一团美国人去这个圣地旅游。
Now you don't see me in that picture because I took the picture.
你看不到我在照片里面，因为我就是那个摄影师。
Yeah, but I took these people to visit the Holy Land. We arrived in Ben Gurion Airport on October 5.
在十月五号那一天，我就把他们接了，就是这一群的旅客接到了。
Look at our faces. They look happy.
你看他们的照片里面的样貌都是非常的高兴。
They look excited.
他们非常的兴奋。
Because they are happy to visit the Holy Land.
他们来到圣地探访旅游是非常快乐的。
But very soon we were challenged.
在不过没有的没有过多久，我们就被挑战了。
October 6, we did a lot of touring in Bethlehem.
在十月六号的时候，我们有很多的旅行。
And on October 7,
在十月七号那一天。
While we were eating breakfast in Bethlehem,
当我们还在伯利恒吃早餐的时候。
We start hearing the sound of bombs.
我们就听到这些爆炸的声音。
Anyway, we decided to go and visit Herodion.
啊，后来我们还是去了这个希律堡来看。
Herodion is a palace that Herod the Great built near Bethlehem.
在伯利恒附近有一个大希律建的这个城堡，叫做希律堡。
So as we were visiting there, we look up in the sky and we see the signs of fighting on top.
当我们在这个希律堡的山顶上的时候，我们就看到当时在这个天空上的这些的爆炸，还有这些的飞弹。
We knew we cannot stay in Bethlehem too long because West Bethlehem is in the West Bank.
啊，我们知道我们不能够再逗留在这个伯利恒很久了，因为伯利恒其实是在这个西岸。
So we went to the hotel immediately, got our bags in our on the top of the van.And we tried to get out of Bethlehem.
所以当我们就赶快回到 hotel， 我们就把我们的这些的包包全部放在我们的车的顶上，我们就要离开了。
We went to three checkpoints.
我们要经过三个哨站。
And the Israeli soldiers did not allow us to cross to Jerusalem.
啊，但是这些的以色列的士兵们不让我们过去。
And we start praying.
我们就祷告。
Lord, we need to get out of Bethlehem.
我们就祷告主啊，我们要离开伯利恒。
It's becoming too dangerous.
啊，因为是越来越危险了。
We went to the fourth checkpoint.
我们走到第四个哨站的时候。
And thank God, the soldier said go.
啊，感谢主，那个士兵放我们走了。
And we were able to get to Jerusalem.
啊，我们就可以过到去这个耶路撒冷。
But then we decided we cannot stay in Jerusalem, so we went to the Galilee.
所以当我们发现到我们不能够再逗留在耶路撒冷的时候，我们就离开去的加利利。
Next, okay. And we started visiting the holy places in the Galilee.
我们在那个时候又开始在加利利看一些的圣地了。
I hope sometime after the war you can also go and visit these beautiful holy places.
我盼望呢，在不久的将来，当这个战争结束的时候，你们也可以过来看看圣地的美貌。
If you go to the Holy Land, make sure your pastor go with you.
当你们去圣地的时候，记得把你的牧师也带去哦。
And you can start now putting your pennies together so that you can pay his way.
Okay, 现在你们就把你们的零头全部收起来啊。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. So this is the church. We call it the Church of the Beatitudes, where Jesus taught, you know, the Sermon on the Mount.
Oh, okay. 这个是巴福山的这个教堂叫做这个就是巴福山的教堂了就是耶稣那个登山宝训的教堂。
So we stayed at the church of the in the Galilee for a few days. Then we heard that our flights back to the United States are canceled and the airport is closed.
所以我们在加利利等了一阵子，后来发现到这个飞机告诉我们的机票已经被取消，因为这个机场已经被关闭了。
So we decided to cross the Jordan River and go to the Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan.
我们就只能够越过这个约旦河，去到了约旦。
And from there we took a flight to Istanbul and from Istanbul back to the United States.
所以我们只能够从约旦坐飞机去到伊斯坦堡。Istanbul is Turkey, right?
Yeah.
在土耳其，然后土耳其再回到美国。
So our Holy Land tour was cut in half.
我们的圣地之旅被剪成一半。
So now we come to the next slide.What caused the current crisis in the Middle East?
所以目前的中东的危机到底它的原因是如何呢？
Here is the question people ask: why did Hamas do what Hamas did?
对，我们都会一直的发问说，为什么哈马斯要发动这个战争在10月7号呢？
Now I want you to know that I'm a Christian.
所以我要让你知道我是一个基督徒。
I'm not a supporter of Hamas.
我并没有支持哈马斯。
So if I am trying to explain why Hamas is doing things, it doesn't mean that I'm supporting them.
好，现在我要告诉你关于这件事情的时候，你不要以一个刻板印象说我是在支持哈马斯，我并没有。
Not only I'm a Christian, but I'm against all kinds of violence.
我不但是一个基督徒，我也反对所有的暴力。
There are some misconceptions.
其实这边有很多一些错误的资讯。
And here is one misconception that many Christians around the world have.
这个错误的资讯可能就是全世界的基督徒都会有这种刻板印象。
The misconception is that Arabs and Jews, Palestinians and Israelis are eternal enemies.
所以我们大概会讲说阿拉伯人和犹太人是世仇。
That is wrong.
这是错的。
We are not eternal enemies.
我们并没有成为世仇。
Yeah, Arabs and Jews lived side by side in the Holy Land for many, many years without war.
所以阿拉伯人跟犹太人其实是他们可以和平的共处了几百年，就是在这个战争之前。
When Jews were persecuted in Europe, they would come to the Middle East.
当犹太人在欧洲被排犹的时候，他们跑到巴勒斯坦，其实是他们是跑到中东。
And they lived under the protection of the Arabs and the Muslims in the Middle East.
当时是中东的这些回教徒在保护他们。
So anybody that tells you that Arabs and Jews have been fighting for millennia, for many, many years, they don't know what they are talking about.
所以当有人跟你讲说犹太人跟这个阿拉伯人是世仇的话，他们其实不知道在讲什么。
Here's the other misconception.
所以这个是另外一个我们的这个错误的资讯。
This is a conflict over religion, Islam against Judaism.
其实这个是一个宗教战争，就是犹太教跟这个回教在彼此对抗。
My friends, I tell you the truth. This is not a conflict about religion.
我告诉你，我的朋友，其实这场不是一个宗教战争。
The Israelis and the Palestinians don't fight because of religious beliefs.
回教这个犹太教跟伊斯兰教，他们不是因为宗教的缘故而打仗。
This is a conflict about territory.
其实这一场的战争是领地的战争。
It's a conflict about land.
是关于土地的战争。
We, the Palestinians, have lived in that country for about 2,000 years.
我们在那块土地，巴勒斯坦人在那块土地已经住了快2000年。
And the Israelis came in 1948 and said, "This is our country. You need to get out."
所以，当1948年，当以色列人来的时候，他就告诉我们说，这是我们的土地，你们要离开。
And of course, we resisted.
当然，我们当然会反对。
And that created wars.
所以，这样就开始了战争。
But it's not about religion; it's about land.
其实不是关宗教的事情，是关土地的事情。
Here is another misconception.
所以另外一个错误的这个印象就是，
Palestinians have no interest in peace. Their goal is the destruction of the state of Israel.
所以巴勒斯坦人其实他们不要和平，他们就是要把以色列毁灭。
I travel all over the world.
我去过全世界各地。
And this is what I hear from many, many people.
其实这个就是我从很多人的口中听到的。
They say, "You Palestinians, you don't want peace with Israel."
所以他说，你们这些巴勒斯坦人就是不要和平，跟以色列和平共处。
But that is not true.
其实那个是错的。
Palestinians will have peace with Israel tomorrow if the Israelis will give us peace, real peace.
如果以色列愿意把真正的和平给我们的话，明天巴勒斯坦人就跟他和好了。
If the Israelis say, "Let's have a two-state solution," we'll say, "Yes, we'll take a two-state solution."
如果他们讲要拿那个两国政策的话，他们说好，我们立刻就已经可以解决这个问题了。
If the Israelis say, "We don't want two states, we just want one state for everybody," we Palestinians will say, "Yes."
当以色列人讲说好，我们不要两国政策，我们要一国政策的话，巴勒斯坦人也讲说好，我们就接受。
So we Palestinians are the, like in the Americans would say, we are the underdog.
我们underdog.
And it means we are the weaker link.
我们就是那个比较受害的那一方。 弱的那一方。
We have been defeated many times.
我们被打败了好多好多次。
And therefore, we are willing to accept any solution that Israel will give us.
我们希望可以从以色列那边得到一切的解决方案。
Except we don't want a solution where the Israelis will dominate us forever.
我们不要接受的就是当以色列要完全的主控全部。
Let's see the fourth assumption, false assumption. The current state of Israel is an extension of biblical Israel.
啊，这个就是现在的以色列国，其实就是圣经里面所说的以色列国。
Many, many Christians around the world, they think the current state of Israel is linked with Israel of the Bible.
其实我们很听很多的基督徒说，啊，这个现在的以色列国就是圣经里面的那个以色列。
Well, there are 2,000 years between the Israel of the Bible and the current Israel.
我们从圣经里面看，就是大概有从圣经里面的以色列一直到现在的以色列有2000年的历史了。
Ancient Israel was built on the prophets and on the Old Testament.
我们看到旧的以色列，就是古时的以色列，是在先知和这个圣经上所建立起来的。
But the current state of Israel is built by a secular atheist Zionist who don't believe in any god or any religion.
现在的以色列国其实是由这个锡安主义还有这些这个无神论者，他们是不相信神的这一群的人建立起来的。
So there is no link between the biblical Israel and the current Israel.
对，现在的以色列跟以前的以色列，他们其实是不一样的。
And okay, now I want to tell you a little bit about myself and my family.
所以现在我要告诉你关于一些我的故事。
I was born in Jerusalem.
我是出生在耶路撒冷。
And what you see is a picture of Jerusalem from Mount Olives.
所以这个就是你在橄榄山上看到的一个照片。
This is my neighborhood in Jerusalem.
这就是我在以色列这个耶路撒冷的我居住的地方。
My family lived in this neighborhood until 1948.
我的家族的人住在这里，一直到1948年。
In 1948, we had a war, and the Jewish militia pushed my family and all the Palestinians who lived in West Jerusalem, and we became refugees.
所以在1948年的时候，这一些的以色列人军队就开始把我们赶出去。
Yes.In that war, my father, even though he was civilian, he was shot and killed.
我的爸爸就是当时是平民百姓，就在那时被打死了。
So he left my mother with 7 children.
他就留下了七个孩子给我妈妈。
Yeah, so here my mother with 7 of us.
那这里就是我的全家福。
Can you figure out where I am on that picture?
你们看哪一个是我啊？
Look at the person with the black hair. That will be me.
啊，那个黑头发的就是我了。Always
black. All right, that was a trick. That I want to see if you are awake or not.
我看你有没有睡着。
Okay, I'm on the extreme left.
Extreme all the way down.
Yeah, the guy with the black belt.
Okay, 那个在。那个、yeah. 左边的那一个 ，OK。
You know, so my mother was left with 7 of us children.
所以我的妈妈就有七个孩子，要抚养七个孩子长大。
But she was a committed Christian.
她是一个非常爱主的基督徒。
She taught us never look back, always look forward.
她告诉我们不要向后看，要向前看。
Never ask why God, always ask how God.
不要问上帝说为什么，而是要问上帝说要怎么做。
And never harbor hatred in your heart. Always forgive.
要不要把仇恨放在心中？要常常原谅。
These are amazing teachings for a woman who lost her husband in a war.
这个是一个来自战争中失去丈夫的一个女人的一个教导。
But I'm so glad that we were raised in a Christian family.
我们感谢主，是因为我在一个基督化的家庭长大。
And my mother turned our home into a church.
我的妈妈后来把我们的家呢，就变成了一个教堂。
And she taught us the Christian principles.
她就教导我们关于基督徒的一些的原则。
So now we go back to the situation today.
我们就回到今天的情况。
And here is a question many people asking.
这可能是大家的问题。
Was Hamas's attack on October 7 unprovoked?
所以 哈马斯是不是在10月7号发动战争呢？
Did the Hamas had a reason to fight?
哈马斯是不是故意的去发动这个战争？
Now again, I want to tell you, I'm not a fan of Hamas.
现在我要再次的重申，我并不是哈马斯的粉丝。
I don't believe in their theology or in their tactics.
我不相信他们的这些的鬼话。
But we have to tell the truth.
我要跟你讲的是真话。
Hamas's attack on October 7 was provoked by, and I'm going to give you three reasons.
我会给你三个理由，为什么哈马斯会发动战争。
The first reason is the blockade of Gaza.
所以第一个就是加沙被封锁。
Gaza was like a prison.
加沙好像一个监狱这样。
This is the map of the Gaza Strip.
所以你看到这个画面里面就是加沙的它的地图。
It's a very small piece of land.
其实是一个很小片的土地。
About 10 miles from east to west.
所以从东到西只有10英里左右。
And about 35 miles from north to south.
如果是从南到北，大概就是35英里左右。
And it has about 2.3 million people.
里面住了230万人。
But the Israelis blockaded Gaza from everywhere.
所以以色列就把这个加沙全部封起来。
From the north, the Gazans can't go out.
所以你在北，你要去出去，你不能出去。
From the east, the Israelis built a big wall.
在东边呢，以色列就把全部的地方都封起来，用一个很大的墙壁把它封起来。
And from the south, the Egyptians have a small opening at the city called Rafah.
所以在拉法，在这个埃及就有一个很小的地方是有一个出口。
And from the seashore, Israeli gunboats would shoot and kill any Palestinian that tries to come to the sea.
在海呢，就是如果当你要游出去的话呢。 这个以色列的这个海军就会向你开枪。
And the Israelis controlled everything.
以色列人把他全部地方已经完全被封锁。
They controlled the water.
他控制了所有的水。
The food.
他控制了所有的食物。
The medicine.
他所有的药物。
Everything was controlled by the Israelis.
全部都被他们控制了。
And for 16 years, the Palestinians have been living like in a big jail.
像16年来，这些巴勒斯坦人就好像住在一个很大的监狱里面。
And they got tired of this.
他们已经非常的厌倦这样的生活。
Oh, I don't have this.
Oh, okay, well, I can skip it.
Okay.
I can skip it. It's okay. Now, I just want to imagine, what if an enemy from outside will come to your country and take a chunk of a land from Malaysia and put a wall around it and separate it from the rest of Malaysia.
所以你想一下，你可以今天想象一下，如果今天有一个仇敌来把马来西亚占领了，然后把你们都圈在一个地方里面，不让你们出去。
Well, sooner or later, the people in Malaysia are going to rebel.
他讲，不论怎样的，到一个地方你忍不住的时候，你就会反抗。
Because nobody wants to live under oppression for so many years.
所以没有人希望会活在一个被压制的空间里面。
So,
2008, yeah,
okay. So this is a picture I took with my camera.
这个是一张我用我的相机拍的照片。
In one of the bombings in 2008, the Israelis bombed Gaza, and then after that, I went to visit Gaza and took this picture.
所以2008年当以色列轰炸这个加沙的时候，他轰炸以后，我过去拍照的。
Also in 2014, many Gazans went to the wall non-violently without any weapons, protesting.
有很多的这些的加沙的巴勒斯坦人就跑到墙的旁边去抗议，没有用武力，只是抗议。
And the Israelis attacked them.
以色列的军队就向他们来攻击。
And killed many Palestinians.
而且向他们开枪，杀死了很多人。
So notice that's before October 7.
这个是在2023年10月7号以前所发生的。
It was big bombardment.
这是一个非常大的轰炸。
Many Gazans were killed and many houses were destroyed.
所以很多的房子被轰炸，然后很多的人死了。
Also, in the year 2021,
在2011年,
the Israelis also killed 230 people in Gaza.
Okay, 2021年以色列人杀了230个巴勒斯坦人。
and made life for the people in Gaza miserable.
所以让加沙的人非常的困难.
It is true that Hamas sometimes throw rockets at Israelis.
是的，当时哈马斯有向他们发射火箭.
But Hamas's rockets are not effective to stand against the Israeli army.
所以哈马斯的火箭是比起以色列的是没有任何的果效.
But when they throw a rocket at Israel, Israel retaliates with 100 rockets.
所以当他们射了火箭过去，以色列就向他们回击那个飞弹.
So this is the reason why October 7.
这是为什么10月7号会发生?
Here is the second reason.
第二个理由,
the unending and illegal occupation of the West Bank.
所以在西岸呢，不是在加沙，在西岸有这些非法的这个占领。
For 56 years, the Gaza Strip and the West Bank were under military occupation.
56年以来，加沙跟西岸都是在军事的管制之下。
And the Palestinians got tired of being occupied by a foreign country.
巴勒斯坦人已经非常的厌倦在这个被别的国家来控制。
So the United Nations General Secretary,
okay, 我们的这个联合国的秘书长呢,
he said this statement.
Okay, 他就说, 我们必须承认哈马斯的攻击是无非无缘无故发生。巴勒斯坦人已经忍受了56年令人窒息的占领行为。Okay.
Yeah,
I can see that. Okay.
All right. In 1993,
在1993年,
there was a peace accord called the Oslo Peace Accords.
有这个的协议，当然要谈的就是这个奥斯陆协议。
And you see in this picture Rabin, Yasser Arafat, and Clinton.
我们看到这个以色列的前总理就是拉宾，还有这个阿拉法，他们还有这个克林顿。
They had an agreement.
他们有一个的协议。
And they shook their hand.
他们已经握手。
And the idea was there will be a Palestinian state in the West Bank and the Gaza Strip after 5 years.
他们会答应说有一个 巴勒斯坦的这个加沙，还有这个西岸的这个的 state 啊，国一个的土地 ，okay.
But a radical Israeli person, he took his gun and shot Rabin and killed him.
所以当这个协议过后没有多久呢，有一个极端的以色列人呢就开枪打死了拉宾，暗杀他。
And the leaders who came after Rabin refused to give the Palestinians a state within 5 years of Oslo.
就是本来是讲好有五年，后来这个拉宾被杀了以后呢，下一个领导就不承认这一个的协议。
Instead of giving the Palestinians a state, they started building Jewish settlements in the West Bank.
所以当他们不但没有给这个答应了的国土地，他们还开始建造。
The map on the left is the West Bank.
所以他就开始建造这些的占领，就是这。
And if you notice, there are dots there.
你看到在左边这个有很多的这个小点。
All of these are Jewish settlements that are built on Palestinian land.
这些就是在巴勒斯坦里面的犹太人的垦殖区，就是他们在这边要占领的。
Not only did the Israelis build Jewish settlements, but they also built bypass roads to divide Palestinians from Palestinians and Palestinians from Israelis.
他们不单单是在里面占领他的土地，还在那边做了很多的路，是企图是要割断他们之间的来往。
Meanwhile, they kept taking Palestinian land and giving it to Jewish people.
所以他们就把这些的割出来的土地，就把它分给很多的犹太人。
So that was frustrating for Palestinians.
所以这样的情况之下呢，就算是属于巴勒斯坦的地，就已经被分割出去，巴勒斯坦人就很不高兴了。
So gradually, the Palestinian land was shrinking.
所以巴勒斯坦的这个地呢，就越来越少。
Look at this map. From the left, you see how Palestine was in
1947.
And the last map, you see how the Palestinian map became like today.
1948年成立以后，我们就看到它的土地是越来越少，到现在。
Just one look at this map tells you the story.
地图你就可以知道现在发生在那边的事情。
Israelis taking Palestinian land and making it their territory.
所以以色列人就跑进来占领巴勒斯坦人的土地，然后变成他们的土地。
Also, the Israelis built wall to separate themselves from Palestinians.
所以当他们占领了，他们就会开始建造这些的墙壁。
But 85% of the wall was within the Palestinian territory.
而且这些的墙壁都是建在巴勒斯坦的土地上。
This is like if you and your neighbor have a quarrel.
当你跟你的邻居如果是跟他发生争吵的时候，
and your neighbor decides to build a wall between you and his house and your house.
当你跟邻居争吵，你的邻居要建这个墙的时候，
but when the neighbor builds his wall, he takes about half of your land.
他建这个墙的时候，他是把你的土地占了一半来建。
You would say this is not fair.
当然你会讲这是不公平啊。
And the Palestinians have been saying it's not fair.
我们巴勒斯坦人就说这是不公平的。
The only reason why the Israelis can get by with this, the only reason why.
为什么，就是唯一这个原因让以色列人会这样做的就是呢？
Is that the United States used its veto power in the United Nations to block the Palestinians from having justice.
所以当这些事情，他们敢这样做，是因为美国会用他的这一个反对票，在联合国里面去反对他们这样做这样的事情。
Even until 2 days ago,
一直到前两天，
all the countries of the world, almost all the world, wanted the ceasefire except the United States and maybe one or two other countries.
所以当他们有这个安全理事会在开的时候，已经是全。 几乎全世界的都要停火的时候。So
the United States used its veto power to block a ceasefire in Gaza.
所以反而美国还是用回那个反对票去禁止这件事情发生。Next.
Okay. Of course, the Palestinians were not quiet.
当然这样子的话，巴勒斯坦人就不高兴。They
revolted.
他就被激怒了。Their
revolt is called Intifada.
Intifada.
Which is uprising. Not surprising.
他们就里面就越来越激动。And
every time they rise up, the Israelis smash them back.
所以当他们每次起来要反抗的时候，就被以色列人打压。But
both in the West Bank and the Gaza Strip, Palestinian young people continue to resist the occupation.
所以当这事情的时候，很多的这些的巴勒斯坦人就一直的这些年轻人就起来反抗。
Okay, here is the third reason for October 7.
所以我们要看第三个理由，为什么哈马斯会发动攻击。The
threat to the Al-Aqsa Mosque.
所以关于这一个，就是在耶路撒冷的金顶回教堂。If
you see this map of Jerusalem,
当你看到这个耶路撒冷的这个土地。The
dome down in the picture is what we call the Al-Aqsa Mosque.
如果你看到这个金顶的回教堂，其实这个就是在耶路撒冷的这个回教的圣地啊。
And the yellow dome is what we call the dome of the rock.
就是那 dome of the rock， dome of the rock 应该怎么讲？那个耶路撒冷的这个奥什么
？It's a big rock with a dome over it.
就是有一块石头上面有一个很大的那个。 清真寺啊，这个大概是。
Well, these are shrines that the Muslims have built 1,600 years ago.
这是在1600年前回教徒建立的一个圣地，它的回教堂。But
now the Israelis, they feel they are powerful.
所以现在以色列人就开始觉得自己有力量了。And
they are saying to the Muslims in Jerusalem, get out of here, we are going to destroy your shrines and build a third temple in place of the Al-Aqsa Mosque.
所以他们就会跟这些的清真寺里面的这些的伊斯啊这些的回教徒说，你们出去，我们要把它毁灭掉，我们要建第三圣殿。
Can you imagine the frustration of Muslims not only in Jerusalem but all around the world?
你可以想象一下，不单单是耶路撒冷的回教徒，你想一下全世界的回教徒会怎么想？
Now I'm not a Muslim, as you know.
当然我不是要赞成这个回教。
And we Christians now, we don't care who owns this.
我们是基督徒，我们其实不在乎谁有的这块土地。
Because Paul taught us that we are the temple of God and God's Spirit lives in us.
所以当保罗告诉我们，我们就是圣灵的殿，神就住在我们里面。
But for Muslims, this is important.
对回教徒来讲，这是他们的圣地。
And when a person like this guy here in this picture,
当这个照片里面这个人。
He is a high-ranking Israeli politician. Goes around and say, "We must destroy the Muslim shrines, and we must build Jewish shrines in them.
他是在以色列里面很重要的政治人物，他就去跟人家讲说，我们要把这个清真寺毁掉，我们要建立第三圣殿。
The Muslims get upset.
所以基督啊，那个回教徒就非常的生气。
So、this is the third reason for October 7. 啊，
这就是为什么十月七号他们会攻击的原因之
三。But there are also long-term causes for October 7.
其实这个也关于很多是很长远的那个的原因。
And these they go even before 1948.
其实这个要往前看的话，是更早以前，在1948年之前。
There was a Jewish propaganda that says Palestine, a land without a people, for the Jews, a people without a land.
啊，有就人，就是有人去跟他们讲说，巴勒斯坦就是一个土地没有人的，要给一个没有土地的人，也就是犹太人。
But you see in the picture here, you see the picture of Haifa before 1948.
啊，你可以看看这个照片里面，这是啊海这个 Haifa 的这个土地哦，在1898年的时候是满满都是人。
It was populated with the Palestinian people.
其实当时已经有很多的巴勒斯坦人是住在这块土地上。
So it's a lie to say that Palestine was empty, that didn't have land people.
所以是一个错误的谎言，说当时的巴勒斯坦是一块啊没有人要的土地。
But Christian Zionists and secular Jewish Zionists, they kept promoting the lie that Palestine has no people.
所以现在你听到可能有人跟你讲说，啊，这些土地是没有人的，就是这些基督教锡安主义的，还有这些啊犹太锡安主义的人，就告诉你这些的事情了。
The guy you see in this picture, his name is Theodor Herzl.
啊，这一个在照片里面的人叫做 Theodor Herzl 啊。
Yes, he's the founder of Zionism.
他就是锡安主义的。就是他创造的。
Yeah, as early as 1895,
在1898年，对。
He said we must get the Palestinians out to the neighboring country and we need to take their place.
我们要把巴勒斯坦的人全部赶出去，我们要住在这里。
So you see, there was a premeditated designed to take over Palestine.
其实在这个你就看得到，这是一个很长远的计划，就已经是要把他们赶走的。
Then the British came up with the Balfour Declaration.
所以当我们看到这个英国人就来了，他就说到这个贝尔福宣言了，他就说，英王陛下政府乐见巴勒斯坦之内成立一个犹太国家。
Yeah.
家园。
So the British.Palestine did not belong to them.
啊，里面是没有犹太啊，那个巴勒斯坦的。
But because they were the empire at that time,
当时英国是帝国。
They decided to take Palestine from Palestinians and give it to the Jewish people.
他们就把巴勒斯坦拿起来，就给了犹太人。
Then Ben Gurion, the first prime minister of Israel.
所以我们看到这个是第一个啊，以色列的第一个总理。
He decided.After partitioning Palestine, we need to take all of Palestine and make it Jewish.
他讲，当他们立了国以后，他们就讲说，我们现在要把全部的巴勒斯坦的土地拿过来，要归回犹太人。
When he said that, most of Palestine was Palestinians, not Jewish.
当他这样讲的时候呢，most of the Palestinians.
Most of Palestine was Palestinian, not Jewish.
当他这样讲的时候，所有的巴勒斯坦人其实是不是犹太人，他们都是巴勒斯坦人。
Here is the map.
所以这是那个土那个地图。
This is Palestine in 1947.
这是1947年的巴勒斯坦。
The dark areas on the map, that's where the Jewish people lived.
其实你看1947以前的时候，那些 highlight 的地方其实就是犹太人的地方。
All the rest was where the Palestinians lived.
其实其他的土地都是巴勒斯坦人居住的。
Just a quick look at this map, you can see that the Palestinians were the majority and they owned most of the land.
如果你这样看的时候，你就知道当时巴勒斯坦人是占大多数，而犹太人是占小数。
This is why it's so difficult for the Palestinians to face this.Situation.
所以这就是为什么犹太人会，这个巴勒斯坦人会觉得是很难接受这样的现在这样的现状。
This is Palestine during the British mandate.
所以当英国人统治的时候呢
，All of this area in the red was called Palestine.
所以整块的土地就被称为巴勒斯坦。
And it was called Palestine until 1948.
这一块土地被称为巴勒斯坦，一直到1948年。
That's when Israel was created.
所以这就是当时在后来就是以色列他们就成立了。
So in 1948, the United Nations partitioned Palestine.
所以当1948年，就是联合国就把巴勒斯坦跟犹太以色列分割了。
The Palestinians who were a majority did not like the partition.
他分割的时候呢，当时占大多数的这些的巴勒斯坦人就很不满意。
The United Nations did not listen to them.
可是联合国不听他们的话。
As a result, we had the first Arab-Israeli war in 1948.
所以当他们这样子一做的时候呢，当以色列一立国的时候，果然就是中东战争就发生了。
So the second map, is the what happened in 1948.
如果你看到第二片的那个地图，就是当这个中东战争第一次打的时候，它发生的事情。
The only thing left for the Palestinians were the shaded areas, the West Bank and the Gaza Strip.
Okay, 所以你看得到那些被 highlight 起来的，就是后来剩下给巴勒斯坦人的土地。
All of these dots are Palestinian towns and villages that were destroyed by the Israeli army in 1948.
所以这些就是当时在1948年被犹太人以色列人打的这些的城市，还有这些乡村。
800,000 Palestinians were forced out of their homes and they became Palestinian refugees.
有大概80万到90万的巴勒斯坦人在那一天就成为了难民，被赶出他们的家园。
They locked their homes and they decided maybe in the future they'll come back.
他们基本上就是把家里的屋子锁了以后就离开，带着锁匙，以为还可以回来。
The United Nations decided to make a resolution to call for the Palestinians to come back.
所以，OK，在。 这个联合国呢，后来就有一个的决议案，就是要叫巴勒斯坦人回来。But
that resolution never did work.
所以这一个的议案呢，没有被通过。Because
of United States using its veto power in the United Nations.
因为美国就用他的这个反对票呢，去反对这个的事情。So
here in this picture, you see two refugees.
所以当这个照片你看的时候，其实就是两
I mean two groups of refugees.
两组不同的难民。
You see on the left, you see the refugees of 1948.
你在左边看到那个就是1948年的难民。
And on the right, you see the refugees of the last few weeks.
你看得到在右边，其实就是在前几周
of the last few months in Gaza.
就前几周发生的，就是在这些加沙的难民。
And this is why the Egyptians don't want to open their borders for the Palestinian refugees because they don't want the same thing to happen like happened in 1948.
所以这就是为什么埃及不肯打开他们的门，是不想要同样的事情发生在他们的国土上。
So as a result of Hamas's attack,
就是当哈马斯开始攻击，在10月7号的时候
，1,200 Israelis, including women and children, were killed.
所以1,200个以色列人，包括妇女、孩子被杀。Over
200 Israelis were taken hostages.
所以有200人大概是被抓成人质。Of
course, as Christians, our heart go, you know. Equally, we are equally sorry for Israeli victims and Palestinian victims.
当然，我们作为基督徒，我们对这样的事情是感到遗憾。
As a result of October 7,
所以当10月7号之后呢,
most hospitals and medical facilities have been destroyed or ordered to evacuate.
所以大多数的医院跟这些的医疗措施是被炸毁。
All schools, churches, mosques, UN shelters, and bakeries have been targeted, and many of them destroyed.
所以，学校、教堂、清真寺、联合国避难所、面包店，成为以色列人打的首要攻击的地方。
Today, no place in Gaza is safe.
在加沙是没有一个地方是安全的。
I used to go to Gaza once a week.
我通常会去加沙一个礼拜一次。
And preach in the Baptist church.
我会在加沙的浸信会来讲道。
The lady who used to play the piano in the church.
那个教堂里面有一个姐妹是为我弹钢琴的。
One day she decided to go out and check to see if her house was bombed by the Israelis or not.
所以有一天她就出去，她要看看她的家是否有被这个以色列攻打炸掉。
So she left the church compound to go to see her house. She was hit by a missile.
她就离开教堂要去看她的家的时候，她就被这个飞弹炸到。
And She fell down, she started bleeding. The people from the church wanted to come and help her, but they couldn't help her because the Israelis were shooting all around.
所以他们教堂里面的人想要出来要帮助这个姐妹，可是不能够出来， 因为军队就在附近，就看到谁出来就会开枪。
And she bled to death.
她就流血过多而死了。
She wasn't Hamas.
她不是一个哈马斯的。
She's a Christian woman.
她是一个基督徒姐妹。
She wasn't a Muslim.
她也不是一个回教徒。
She has nothing to do with fighting.
她也没有。 打仗也没有做什么这些战争的事。
And many, many innocent people, even children, have been killed.
其实有很多很多这些的基督啊，这些的人，还有包括孩子、婴孩都被杀。
Today, the number of people killed is almost 30,000 people.
啊，今天我们知道呢，大概接近3万人被杀。
75% of all homes have and buildings have been destroyed.
75% 的这些的房子还有这些的建筑物都已经被摧毁了。
And 1.8 million Palestinians were ordered to leave their homes.
所以180万的巴勒斯坦人已经离开家园，成为了难民。
Also in the West Bank, hundreds of Palestinians were killed.
其实，在西岸呢，其实也有很多的这些的巴勒斯坦人被杀。
In Bethlehem, about 70% unemployment.
在伯利恒有70%的这个失业率。
Nothing justifies the killing of journalists.
所以也没有办法来衡量这些被杀的记者哦。
Over 70 journalists have been killed since the start of the war.
当这个战争打的时候呢，也接近70到80的记者被杀。
Nothing justifies the killing of doctors and nurses.
所以也没有东西可以让我们看到，就是这些医生跟护士是被杀的。
Nothing justifies the killing of children.
也包括这些无辜的孩子。
Over 10,000 children, some of them are babies, infants, have been killed.
有超过10,000的数目，这些孩子婴孩是被杀。
Now, why do the Israeli soldiers do that?
那为什么以色列的军队要这样做呢？
Let me give you a secret.
我给你一个秘密。
This is a chief Israeli rabbi.
这是一个以色列的拉比。
And he said,
他这样说呢，
Kill Palestinians to get closer to God.
你只要杀巴勒斯坦人，你就越来越靠近上帝了。
He also said,
他也这样说，
The Palestinians are monsters, and killing them is a religious duty.
所以杀这些巴勒斯坦人是你宗教的义务，所以因为巴勒斯坦人都是怪物。
Well, when this is a chief rabbi and he says that to his soldiers, then his soldiers is going to do what he is saying.
所以当他就这样跟他的军人讲，所以这些军人就这样做了。
This is another Israeli leader.
所以这是另外一个以色列的领袖。
And this is what she said.
他就这样说了。
She called for the genocide of Palestinians and gets thousands of Facebook likes.
所以他就这样说，他说，就是在巴勒斯坦做的这一些的种族灭绝这个屠杀呢，你会得到很多 Facebook 的 like.
She calls for the slaughter of Palestinian mothers who deliver birth to little snakes.
他就称那一些。 巴勒斯坦的妈妈生出的孩子都叫做小蛇。
This is the current president of the state of Israel.
所以这个是现在以色列人的他们的领袖。
And he said this.
他就说，这是整个民族的责任，普罗大众并不知情，没有参与这种言论是绝对不是事实。
You know what this means?
你明白这是什么意思吗？
All Palestinians are Hamas.
所以所有的巴勒斯坦人就是哈马斯。All
Palestinians are fighters.
所以所有的巴勒斯坦人就是那个恐怖分子。All
Palestinians are guilty.
所以所有的巴勒斯坦人都该死。No
Palestinian is innocent.
所以没有一个巴勒斯坦人不是无辜的。Therefore
we have the right to kill them.
所以我们杀他是做对的事。Now
here is the question.
所以这里有个问题。What
would Jesus do?
所以耶稣会怎么做？
Before I'll tell you what Jesus will do, let's read this from the book of Proverbs.
所以如果我再跟你讲先，我会先读这个箴言给你听。
He said, rescue those being led away to death.
Okay, 人被拉到死亡, 你要解救, 人将被杀, 你必须拦阻。
Hold back those staggering towards slaughter.
Yeah,
okay. Okay, let's go to the Good Samaritan.
还记得的话就是撒玛利亚人的故事。
This is what Jesus is saying to us Christians, how to respond to a genocide.
所以这个就是耶稣现在向这些基督徒来发问说, 当你看到一个被杀害的人, 你要怎么做?
5 ways Jesus told us to respond to a genocide.
所以耶稣告诉你要回应这种的暴力的5个方法。
Let me explain to you these 5 ways.
让我告诉你这5个方法。
Number one,
第一个,
Jesus said, and when he saw him,
耶稣说, 当这一个人看见他的时候,
so the first thing is you need to open your eyes and see the real story.
所以你必须要睁开你的眼睛去看到这些真正发生的事情。
Get a true vision of what's happening there.
你要看见发生在当地的事情。
Don't depend on the media. You need to find out the truth for yourself.
所以你必须要去看到真正发生在那边的事情，不要从媒体里面得到知识。
So the Samaritan, he dared to look at injustice.
所以这一个撒玛利亚人，他是看到这样的事情。
You know, the priest and the Levite kept walking, but the Samaritan took a good look.
当时这个故事里面的这个利未人，还有这个祭司，他。 走了，他们不看，反而是撒玛利亚人看见了。
The second step，
第二个事情就是
，He was moved with compassion。
我们看到这一个好撒玛利亚人就动了慈心。
I have a feeling when you see the views on TV, what's happening to the Palestinians, many of you are moved with compassion。
所以当你看到这个电视上如果有播报这种的杀害的情景的时候，你会感觉到难过伤心。
But if 10,000 children get killed within 4 months, your heart doesn't move with compassion, then ask yourself, what's wrong with me?
是，所以当你在看到10万个婴孩被杀，在这4个月里面看到10万个婴孩被杀，而你的心已经不再有任何的感动的时候，你要问你自己到底发生了什么事。
The Samaritan dared to feel the impact of injustice.
这个好撒玛利亚人去感受了他的这个的慈心。
Number three.
第三个。
He drew near him.
他 往前,
means he drew closer. While the others ran away, the Samaritans drew closer.
当他看到这个被打到半死的人的时候，他是向前去，而那两个祭司跟利未人是离开的。
I think the fact that your pastor allowed me to talk here, you are willing to draw closer.
所以今天当你们来这里听这个讲座的时候，你就是愿意走进来，要明白，要上前来听的。
I know there are many churches in Malaysia, in Kuala Lumpur, who would never ask people like me to speak.
我知道在马来西亚可能有很多的教堂教会呢是不会叫我来分享的。
But we need to have the courage to come close.
我们要有这个上前来的勇气。
He dared to serve, number four.
第四个就是他要去服侍他们。
You know, he bandaged his wounds, he poured oil and wine and put the man on his donkey and took him to the inn.
他用油倒在他的伤处包裹好了，扶他上到自己的牲口，又带他到旅店里面照应他。
He ministered to him.
这一个好撒玛利亚人是去照顾他，去服侍他。
I hope soon that the war will stop in Gaza.
我希望在不久的将来，这场战争会结束。
And Christians in Malaysia would be asking the question, how can we help the people who are suffering there?
所以可能我们会问，我们在马来西亚的基督徒会问说，我们可以如何帮助在加沙的这些难民们？
The last thing he did,
最后一样他做的事情就是,
he got into his pocket, he got his billfold, and he offered money to take care of him until he comes back.
所以这边他就说他敢于施舍，就是在第二天他拿了2个硬币来给了店主说，你照顾他回来，我要还你。
So we don't only look and cry tears when we see the situation on our TV. But then we act and we give.
所以我们不单单只是看电视，我们流眼泪，我们感到这个难过，我们还要赋予行动。我们会在，我们也会施舍。
So this is my message to Malaysian Christians.
所以今天就是我要对马来西亚的基督徒所讲的这个信息。
Dare to look.
敢去看
，dare to feel，
敢去感受
，dare to come close，
敢去靠近
，dare to act，
敢去服事
，dare to give，
敢去施舍
，because Jesus said，
啊，因为耶稣说
，go and do likewise，
所以耶稣说你也照样去做吧。
There is hope，
其实是我们有盼望。
When I look at these faces in this picture，
当你看到照片里面的这些的脸的时候
，I know there is hope，
我们就知道有盼望。
Gandhi lived under British occupation in India。
当时甘地，圣雄甘地是在英国统治的印度。
Martin Luther King lived under an apartheid system in United States。
在马丁路德金当时是最啊是在那一个啊白人黑人在对立的那种的年代。
And Nelson Mandela lived under apartheid system in South Africa。
啊，曼德拉我们也知道他上次是在一个非常不公平、不正义的这个种族政策的里面。
But all of them succeeded to get rid of injustice。
所以他们面对了，他们也成功的去。纠正了这个的政策。
And I hope the world will come close to Palestinians and help us get rid of the injustice.
我们也我希望呢，这个全世界上的人可以来帮助，来把这个事情来正视。
So where do Palestinians get hope?
所以当作为巴勒斯坦人，我们从哪里得到盼望呢
？Palestinians find hope in Christians around the world and in Malaysia, who are joining us in prayer and intercession for peace and justice.
所以巴勒斯坦人会从世界上所有的基督徒里面一起的得到这个和平。当我们愿意为公义和这个慈爱还有这个祷告的时候呢，我们从他的身上可以得到盼望。
On behalf of all Palestinians, I beg you to pray for peace and justice for all Palestinians and all Israelis.
身为一个巴勒斯坦人，我向你们呼吁，为我们巴勒斯坦人来祷告，求神的公义还有神的慈爱临到他们。
Palestinians find hope in the International Court of Justice and other UN and human rights organizations.Ruling on Israeli's genocide.
所以我们也希望可以从这个国际法庭，还有这个联合国里面得到这个，希望可以从那边得到这个应得的这个正义，还有这个公义的判决。
Palestinians find hope in the masses of people all over the world who went out to the streets to demonstrate.And ask their leaders to end the genocide.
巴勒斯坦人也会从这些现在在世界各地不断的向他们的政府来施压的这些的示威的人士来得到盼望。
And if Palestinian Muslims go to the streets in Malaysia, I hope some Christians will join them.
Oh, they already did.
They already did. Hallelujah. Thank God.
No Christian.
Oh, but no Christian.
But the time when the Muslim already.
Next time there is a demonstration, I would love to see Muslims and Christians saying no genocide, no genocide, no genocide.
所以我希望下一次看得到的就是当这些向政府施压的时候，我们希望就是不要有任何的这种的种族灭绝的事情发生。
Where do Palestinians find hope?
当然，我们从哪里得到盼望呢
？Palestinians find hope for, in take away Hong Kong, put Malaysia.
当然，巴勒斯坦人可以从这个马来西亚的
people in Malaysia who are deeply concerned about justice and peace in the Holy Land.
希望可以从马来西亚人的身上得到这个盼望。
This picture was taken in Hong Kong.
这个照片是从香港的教会拍的。
Next picture will be Malaysia.
下一张就是从我们这边拍。
And I'll leave you with this.
I don't have this.
Oh, you don't have it?
Okay.
Okay. I'll just say it. Justice and only justice.
就是公义，唯有公义。
That's it?
Yeah.
Well, thank you for listening to me.
谢谢大家的聆听。
You are brave to invite me.
你们很勇敢，你们敢邀请我来。
And I appreciate you listening to the other side of the story.
我感谢你们的收，你们愿意听另外一边的事情。
When you go home,
当你回家的时候
，pray.
希望你们可以祷告。
And say, Lord, what do you want me to do about this?
你们可以祷告说，主啊，我应该为这件事情，我应该怎么做
？And let the Spirit of God speak to you.
让神的灵向我们来说话。
May God bless you.
上帝祝福你们。
May God bless Malaysia.
上帝祝福马来西亚。
All the people of Malaysia.
也祝福所有的马来西亚。
And especially the church in Malaysia.
所以当然也为这教会来祷告。
God bless you.
上帝祝福你们。
Thank you.
Okay. 让我们谢谢 Reverend Alex Awad 为我们带来。 至少我们比较忽略另外一面的故事。
We are glad that Pastor Alex Awad gave us the another side of the story.
弟兄姐妹，我们现在有一点点的时间，如果大家有任何想要询问，是有关巴勒斯坦地的教会、巴勒斯坦难民等等的问题，我们欢迎大家可以出来，把你的问题提出来。
我们现在有这个we have this question and answer sessions. So if you have any question you want to ask, you can actually come forward and ask the questions.
当然我们先讲明哦，Reverend Alex Howard 不是一个政治人物哦，不要出来问他，这样到底那个政策啊，那些那个政府要做决定，而且他不能代表那些政府那些政治人物来做回答。
So we have to understand that Pastor Alex is not a politician, so don't come and ask about the strategies and all this question. Okay.
不晓得有人有任何问题想要询问吗？
There's any question to ask, you can just raise your hand. 可以吗？够长
啊，可以。
不够长了吧
？We need mic。
好好。
Online cannot hear。
Okay, you can stand.
Pastor, do you have right to vote in the Parliament of Israel?
Did you ask a question?
Yeah.
What was it?
You as a Israel Palestine, do you have right to vote in the Knesset?
I didn't understand the question.
The voting right.
Do we have the
voting
right?
Voting
what? Sorry.
Palestine to vote in Israel government.
Voting rights.
Yeah.
Voting. Israel government.
Yeah.
No, he's not. He's a Palestinian. He's not Israel.
I'm a Palestinian, not Israeli. Yeah.
So.But you
I can vote, yeah. I can vote.
You can vote.
I can vote in American because I am an American citizen.
In fact,
I can vote in America, yeah. What's the question?
This is a bright side of a lot because you have begin to have a right to control the, to have certain power in the...
No. He's a Palestinian, but he's not an Israel.
He has the right to vote. No.
Yes. No, I have no right to vote for Israel because most...
He have no right.
Only Palestinians who live in Israel proper can vote, but Palestinians in the West Bank cannot vote. And I only have an American passport, not an Israeli or a Palestinian passport, therefore I cannot vote.
Okay.
Yeah, already answered.
There is hope that the Palestinian can vote in the Israel government. It's a hope.
And then
this is the direction that we lead to this peace and no more fight. So the number of Palestinians in the Israel government is getting bigger and bigger. So
interpret for me, I cannot understand.
He said, I don't understand. I want someone.
He asked, 牧师有没有资格成为以色列的选民去换以色列政府。牧师已经回答了，其实牧师没有这个权利的。
You ask them whether you have the right to become an Israeli to vote and to change the government of the Israeli.
No, I don't have the right. I'm not allowed even to go and live in my country. I'm not allowed to go and live in Israel.
I appreciate that.
I only can go and visit, but I'm not allowed to go and live there.
Okay.
Yeah, already answered the question. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. 其他人有问题吗？
好，来，其他人有任何问题，我们可以这个时候提出。我刚才我提醒了各位，大概政治的问题没有办法在这里讨论的Yes, please come.
Good evening, Reverend Dr. Alex. Thank you so much for coming here and share your story with us. If
you are
I'm not
welcome.
Mistaken, there's this big conception among general Christians, maybe not a very learned one, but generally Christians feel that we need to support Israel. Having the thinking that or the second coming of Christ, that when he comes, he's going to come to the promised land. So whatever that is called Israel, that is where Jesus will come again. So some Christians might feel that we cannot support so-called the Palestinian or... No, we feel that we need to support Israel and whatever they are doing, which of course is not the real thing. So maybe, I'm not sure if I missed it, that when you share, you can... I think you share a little bit about what Israel is today. It's not what Israel is during the Bible time, the Old Testament time. And when we talk about the second coming of Christ, when Jesus comes again, it's not that he's going to come to the present land that is called Israel today.
Yeah.
Eh?
Yeah. I have a whole lecture, and it is, if you bought my book, it is chapter 10. Chapter 10 in my book actually answers your question in details. However, just to say short, today God's people, according to the New Testament, are people who believe in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, not people who are ethnically Jews or ethnically Palestinians or ethnically Egyptians or Americans or Malaysians, because, the Bible say he came to his own. His own did not receive him, but as many as received him, they became the children of God. His own is the Jewish people. But he said, as many as believed him, they became the children. And Paul says, we are all God's children through faith in Jesus Christ. No Jew anymore, no Gentile anymore, no Greek, no barbarian, no Roman. We are all God's children through faith in Jesus Christ. Think about it. When Jesus died on the cross, he took away those barriers between Jews and Gentiles. Anyone who comes to Christ, whether he's Jew or Gentile, Christ accepts him. That's the New Testament teaching, and we need to hold. Anytime a teaching say, oh, this country is special, this is God's chosen people, that's not the New Testament.
Yeah, 我快快翻译一下啊，刚才姐妹问的问题就是，今天很多基督徒都有这样的相信，就是，我们一定要支持以色列，因为根据传统的一些教导，基督要再来。 所以我们要支持以色列，因为基督会降临在他的子民当中等等。所以就被迫，不管现在以色列做什么，我们都不可能支持以色列的另外一side的了。我们一定要支持上帝的选民。可是牧师的回答就是，这个并不是新约的教导。新约教导很清楚告诉我们，他到自己的地方来，自己的人就是以色列人、犹太人，倒不接待他，凡接待他的就是信他名的人，就成为神的儿女。所以谁是神的儿女呢？在新约。 不管犹太人，不管希腊人，不管外邦人，所有都是神儿女。只要接待他的，所以我们就是上帝的子民，教会就是上帝的子民。因此，我们就不再需要回到那个血缘上，那个种族上，那一个上帝的子民。他不需要有特别一个这样的组别，因为所有凡是接待他的，都成为了上帝的子民。这个图是牧师的书里面很清楚有。 列出来这个回答这个问题的，就是到底我们是不是要支持现在国籍或者种族上的以色列人成为上帝的子民啊？这个不是新约的教导，因为新约教导是耶稣基督已经把那个犹太人外邦人墙拆毁了，所以上帝的子民就是教会。好 ，Come please.
Yeah, you can actually explain this one.
Yeah, if you look at the top line. Yeah, look at the top line. Would you read the top line, please?
我们来看看最上面新旧业两月之间的比较。Now
the middle line. Read the middle line.
Middle line. Okay. The Israel.
No. For in Chinese.
Okay. 中间那边你可以看到旧业那边的那个列出来的以色列应许之地耶路撒冷锡安山利未家，然后先知用动物 ，okay。
Now look at the bottom line.
然后来到新约的时候呢，国度已经不再是用以色列，是所有的信徒。然后圣地不再是应许之地，是上帝的国。然后圣城就已经变不再是那个 地图上耶路撒冷是新耶路撒冷，然后圣殿不再是那个锡安山，是圣信徒的内心，然后祭司的职分不再是利未族，是所有的基督的信徒。
We are as Christians, we are at the bottom line.
Yeah, 我们是在看不到那个，
啊，
不要紧。总之，我们已经不再是旧约时代中间那一行了，我们是最下面那一排，我们是新约时代。
And Christian Zionism tries to reverse this.
基督徒锡安主义很想把这个秩序重新倒带回去，回到旧约时代。
They want to tell us that the Jews are forever God's chosen people.
他们要告诉我们，犹太人作为种族性的犹太人是永远上帝的子民。
But Paul himself, he said, a Jew is not a Jew who is just circumcised. He is just Jew in the flesh.
可是保罗已经说了。已经不要用肉体犹太人割礼或者不割礼，已经不用这样来分了。
The Jew, real Jew is the Jew in the spirit.
真犹太人，真以色列人是心灵上受割礼的。
And that's all of us who accept Jesus as Lord and Savior.
我们所有人接受耶稣基督成为救主的。
So does God love the Jews still? Does God still love the Jews?
上帝还爱犹太人吗？
Of course he does.
当然他爱犹太人。
But Jews without Jesus are nothing. Jews without Jesus are nothing.
可是如果犹太人不相信耶稣，他们也没有办法得救啊。
Muslims without Jesus are nothing. Muslims without Jesus are nothing.
穆斯林没有办法相信耶稣，他们也没有办法得救。
You know, our salvation depends on Jesus Christ.
我们的救恩是建基在耶稣基督身上。
Yes, God loves the Jewish people and the Muslim people.
上帝爱犹太人，上帝也爱所有的穆斯林。
But the Bible teaches us that salvation is through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
可是圣经告诉我们，救恩是建基在耶稣基督的死和复活上。
Thank you.
我们还有其他问题吗？ Any more question?Okay, we have the final one, okay? Come, please.
The last word is animal sacrifice. Animal sacrifice. No, the last one is Jesus dying on the cross.
Okay. 那个盖这了，是耶稣基督死在十字架上。
就
不再用动物来献祭，是耶稣献了最美好的祭。Okay, 好 come.
Hi, Pastor Alex.
Yes.
I have three questions.The first question is there any, I believe there is minority Christian living in Israel. Is there any initiative raised by the local church in Israel that against the act of Israel to attack Palestine? Is the first question. Second
question. Let me answer this question quickly.
One by one.
Yes, there are some Messianic Jews who feel like they are brothers and sisters to Palestinian Christians. And we are in the same boat because we have one Lord, one Redeemer, Jesus Christ, whether we are Jewish believers or Palestinian believers.
那些相信弥赛亚的犹太人，事实上他们是跟巴勒斯坦的基督徒站在同一阵线的。
So the second question.
The second question is, I'm more concerned on the faith of the Palestinian refugees. Where are they going? Like after the wars, which countries are they heading to?
The Gaza refugees, where are they going? Is that the question? Well, no country in the world wants them.No Arab country, no Christian country, no Islamic country wants the Palestinian refugees. Therefore, they are not going anywhere.
A lot of them in Malaysia.
Yes, they are going to stay there under the bombardments.
Yeah. 巴勒斯坦的难民可以去什么国家？基本上世界上好多国家都不接受巴勒斯坦难民。基督徒国家不接受，这个阿拉伯国家不接受，所以巴勒斯坦难民其实是很没有办法去其他地方。Any question?
The question is there any local NGO in Malaysia that support to this Palestine, like any food donation or any helping aids to them?
There are lots of nations that are supporting the Palestinian people, but they cannot help the Palestinians in Gaza because the Israelis will not allow the international community to come to Gaza and help the Palestinians.
有没有一些非政府组织是支持巴勒斯坦难民的呢？牧师的回答是：事实上，全世界有好多人、好多地方都支持巴勒斯坦难民。不过，很多时候那些援助没有办法真正进到巴勒斯坦地，因为以色列政府把它隔绝了嘛。
I know Malaysia will send 100 trucks full of food to Gaza if the Israelis would allow them to do so.
以色列在马来西亚也有人送了很多车的这个援助要进到去巴勒斯坦地，不过以色列政府给不给他进去咯？
But the Israelis are using hunger for political reasons. The Israelis are using hunger, starvation as a political tool.
他就让巴勒斯坦人陷入那种饥饿痛苦当中，这都是一些政治手段了。Thank
you, Pastor Alex.
Sisi. Welcome.
好，我们再次掌声谢谢 Pastor Alex. Thank you, Pastor Alex, for your wonderful sharing. 那各位，今天晚上我觉得，当我们听了 Pastor Alex 分享过后呢，除了知道多一些，我觉得我们有一样东西是一定要做，我们才可以离开的。啊，
弟兄姐妹，今天晚上我们。没有反应我。哦，OK。 Brother and sister, when we heard about all this information that we get from Pastor Alex, we knew about it and we have something to do before we left. Let us pray for Palestine.
我们祈求上帝的怜悯和公义临到他所爱的巴勒斯坦人。
We ask the mercy of God and the justice will reach Palestine.
我们祈求上帝透过国际各方的施压能够停火。
We also ask that Lord will through the
International pressure
to stop the war.
我们一起开声祷告。
Let us pray out loud for Palestine.
然后过后我们请史汉牧师带领我们来祷告。
After that, we will end the session with prayer. So let us pray together. 我们一起开声来为巴勒斯坦祷告。过后我会带领大家做结束的祷告。
让我们一起祷告。
Let us pray together. 天父，我们来到你的面前，我们要为我们的弟兄姐妹祷告。主啊，我们看到他们忍受这个战火，他们面对这些不公的攻击，还有甚至失去家园、失去亲人。 我们为着他们所承受的一切，我们祈求神的怜悯可以临到他们。主啊，巴勒斯坦、以色列都是你的，我们把他们所经历的苦难交在你的手中。但愿你的安慰临到每一个受苦的灵魂，也但愿主你的救恩来破除这些的罪恶。 破除这些的仇恨。但愿正如好像保罗所说的，耶稣基督的福音要打破这两道的墙，好让他们可以重新合一，在耶稣基督里面成为一个爱主的国度。天父啊，我们祈求你的国度就临到这片的土地。这场的战争，我们祈求你怜悯。我们看到这些哀哭的灵魂，我们求主安慰，求主拯救。我们也求主借着国际的力量，让这一场的战争战火可以早日停息。主啊，我们这一些在马来西亚的基督徒也向你祷告。我们虽然在这里好像过得非常的安逸，但是在这时候我们也知道，在世界的角落有这一群一样是信奉你的，也是在苦难的里面，在哀求，在呼求主你的怜悯。主啊，但愿你再次的把这样的心智放在我们的心上，好让弟兄姐妹基督徒我们可以同心合一来祷告。但愿平安临到我们所爱的弟兄们，巴勒斯坦的弟兄们，以色列的弟兄们的身上。我们祈求你的怜悯，感谢主，我们为着我们的 Pastor Alex 祷告，求你也祝福他以下的事工，给他有精神体力，让他的分享在每一个事情上都能够荣耀你的圣名。感谢主，我们就将仰望祷告，奉耶稣的名，阿们。还有书吗？
没有，卖完了。
OK。
我如果还要订书的话 ，I mean 这里实体聚会的弟兄姐妹可以跟 Kim 留个名字，我们看看可以怎样再订购更多的书进来。
So if you want to buy the books, for those who read English, so you can go Amazon. They actually the English version is Amazon. There you can buy it. So 那个要买中文版的，可以向 Kim 姐妹来购买。也希望。如果你们要的话，今天我们书是卖完了哦，因为刚刚一来就抢完了，所以你们要的话给名字我们，然后我们再跟你安排。
我们要给是你要给白五、你要给他白五，然后再给他1100，
一定给
了，给了吧，所以现在我们最后就是我们请我们的主席来给他一个。Pastor Alex, we want to give you a token of appreciation. So our chairman will... OK，如果你们有兴趣知道，其实他的解释就是旧约的话，就是这几个上面就是圣经应许的，然后在新约的时候就是这些，然后在耶稣里面已经完全不一样了。OK。如果你们要这个 PowerPoint 整个的话，我已经跟牧师拿了。如果你要的话，可以找我，我会把这个 PowerPoint 给你。So。Can I get the English version from you also? Yeah, 英文的跟中文的都有。The English and the Chinese version. So if you want, you let me know. I WhatsApp and I send to you. Okay. So 我们暂时。